Everyone knows you can use an edge finder to locate the edge of a part, but did you also know that you can use one to locate the center of a hole? If not, stick around and I'll show you how it's done. This technique works on pretty much any size hole, from great big ones down to ones you can barely get the edge finder in, but it works pretty consistently over all diameters. This is about a 400 thousandths diameter hole that I bored in this piece of scrap a few minutes ago, so it's a nice round hole. Should be easy to pick up the sides of it. So let's turn the machine on and see if we can't find the center of this hole. Just put your edge finder in somewhere near the center of it. Just eyeball it. It's not that critical. Let's go back and pick up the back side of the hole first on the y-axis. Just run back to your edge finder, jumps off to the side. Okay, now this technique works best with a digital readout. You can do it with without one, but you have to compensate for the backlash in your lead screw, so it makes it a little cumbersome. All right, let's go up and pick up the front edge of the hole on the y-axis. Okay, now I have a midpoint function on this readout. If you don't have one, you can still do it. You have to do the math with your calculator. Okay, so we're centered up on the Y. Let's do the same thing on the X. First, let's crank the Y back near the center of the hole. Doesn't have to be exact. And we'll pick up the far side on the X-axis. Zero out our X-axis. And come back and pick up the near side. Use the midpoint function on X, apply it to X. All right, let's see how well we did here. We run back to 0, 0. We should be on the center of the hole. And when I bored this hole a few minutes ago, I was in the absolute mode, and I zeroed out the X and Y axis in that mode. Now you can see we're in the incremental mode. So let's switch over to absolute and see how close we got. Darn, I missed one by 2/10. All right, that's pretty darn good. That's how you use an edge finder to locate the center of a hole.